Hello and welcome. This is Perspectives on your number one television, OSL, so the nation's star station. Right now, we are at the Constituency House of Senator Dr. Pat Ayo Akinyelure, is a senator representing Ondo Central Senatorial District and the Chairman Senate Committee on Ethics, Privileges and Public Petitions. Honorable, good to have you in the House. Can we meet you, sir?
Yeah, thank you very much. My name is Distinguished Senator Ayo Akinyelure, FCA, the Chairman Senate Committee on Ethics, Privileges and Public Petition, representing Ondo Central Senatorial District at the upper chamber of the National Assembly.
What was growing up like for you?
Well, we give glory to God. I'm a chartered accountant by profession, a trained chartered accountant by training. I've been in practice for over two decades before being elected to represent my people at the upper chamber of the National Assembly. And by the grace of God today, Rome is never built in a day, like we rightly said. I've been an entrepreneur throughout my life. Have never earned a salary in my life because I believe in education for responsibility, education for self-reliance. Education for honesty and dedication to what I believe in. And that is what I have been. I've been an entrepreneur throughout the days of my life, up to the present moment. I trained as a chartered accountant. I qualified as a chartered accountant when I was in the 200 level in the government, 300 level in the polytechnic. And when I left polytechnic, I qualified as a chartered accountant. There and then, I looked for a job in the banking industry, no way. And as good we have it, on a particular day, I just decided that I'm not going to look for a job again. When the system disallowed me from being an employee, then the opposite of employee, to be an employer of labor. At that point, I decided to, you know, be an employer of labor. And I went to Otta. Sangwater to rent a room and parlor apartment, you know, in a shopping complex. And I made up my mind that I'm going to make a success of my endeavor as a chartered accountant in practice. I started training accountancy and banking students. And that is what metamorphosed to be a polytechnic today in Otta. But I will be asking, why do I set up my polytechnic in Otta? You see, you don't forget your source. When I started training accountancy and banking students in, as far back as 1986-87 in Urban Bashi Shopping Center in Otta, a lot of people thought that I'm just playing. But as God we have it, the first set of students I trained in 1987 for ICANN and AIB students, they all passed the exams. And then the following diet, I recorded over 135 students. And then the problem I had then was, where do I put this set of students? We need room and parlor apartment. And as God we have it, I told God, I said, come, I am determined to succeed as an entrepreneur. And therefore, God should support me. And God provided a platform in AMJ area of Lagos State to get me a five-bedroom apartment where I started training accountancy and banking student. And to God be the glory, what I was looking for to go and work in the bank, I got it. Then I am so much in love with cars. I was so much in love to ride the 504 GRAC. And I believe the best way to ride is if I get a job in the bank and I am qualified and I am confirmed as a staff, I'll be able to get a loan of 9,600, which will translate to 150% of my basic salary of 7,200 per annum them in the banking industry. And since there was no way in the banking industry, I started these training programs. And after three or four days, I was able to get, you know, money to buy this car on cash and carry basis. And since that day, I never bought anything on credit any longer. I've been an employer of labor. I've been engaging people to feed people. And that is what I believe in. So thereafter, the program continued, the school started expanding, and to God be the glory, at a point I said, well, this school has to metamorphose to be a polytechnician. And Bagyo, when I made effort to go to Kaduna, I was able to get a license finally in 2002 to establish the first private polytechnic ever licensed in Ogun State, and the first Ondo State indigenous to be licensed to run a polytechnic in Nigeria. And by the grace of God today, that polytechnic, you know, is providing job for over 150 Nigerians. And for every Nigerian who is gainfully employed has about 5 dependents. If you multiply 5 dependents with 150, you know how many people that polytechnic is engaging today. And that is the spirit for which I went to the Senate. I'm a chartered accountant in practice, like I said. I'm a revenue consultant to Ministry Government, Lagos State Government, Ogun State Government, Oyo State Government, Ekiti State Government. I have been acted in my professional capacity to generate revenue for them in the past. I make good money in my professional practice. And I believe that the best thing when you make money in this economy is to give back to the system again.
At what point did you decide to join politics and why?
Well, you see, when I've reached the outcome of my profession, I've made success in my profession, I believe that, you know, giving scholarship to people alone, assisting the needy, is not enough. The question now is service to my people. In 2001, I came to the politics of Ondo State from Lagos, and I joined the AD, Action of Alarm for Democracy then. My first attempt to be a senator then was ditched by some of my people who believed that this young man cannot just come from Lagos, you know, to come and be a leader here. And the process was deemed and was ditched. But because of the fact that I came purposely to come and serve my people, to come and give service to them, I continued. So before eventually I succeeded in 2011, it was somewhere about 9.5 years that I've been paying my price to serve my people. And today, I give glory to God that finally, on April 9, 2011, the people of Ondo Central unanimously gave me the mandate to go and represent them at the Upper Chamber of the National Assembly. And since then, I've been doing what is humanly possible at my disposal to ensure that I serve my people.
What are the functions of a senator?
Well, purely, you see, when you talk about function or responsibilities of a senator, I'm representing a central district. There are 109 central districts in Nigeria. And by the grace of God, Ondo State is one of the central districts that is being represented in the Senate. I'm representing my people to make laws for the good governance of this country. This is purely the responsibility of a senator. A senator is a representative of the people at either at the upper chamber of the National Assembly. Nigeria is a constituent, and therefore we have 109 senatorial districts, of which Ondo State is Ondo Central is one. Ondo Central today is being represented by my distinguished self at the upper chamber of Nigeria to make laws for good governance of Nigeria, to add value to my people by demanding for our own share of national cake in terms of road infrastructure, in terms of education, in terms of agricultural development, in terms of all other infrastructure development that is being distributed at the center. The senator is there to represent and claim the right of his own people. And that is what I've been doing since I've been in the Senate since June 2011, that we were inaugurated in this, that is in the seventh assembly.
What and what have you done for your people since assumption of office?
A lot have been done. Let me first of all thank God for giving me this, for my people giving me this opportunity to represent the upper chamber of the National Assembly. The last 12 years before my inauguration to represent my people at the upper chamber of the National Assembly, people don't even know what a senator can do prior to my, you know, being elected. But today, I think the people know that it is, you see, when you have a senator that is responsive, that has vision, that has passion for his people, a lot can be done. In the last 2.5 years, I'm bold to say that have been able to use that position that belonged to my people to what? To secure just for over 135 graduates employed, gainfully employed at both federal parasitas and the public sector endeavor in this country. That has never happened in the history of Ondo State, even in the history of any place in Nigeria. A senator can, facilitate, sponsor candidates, and within 2 years, securing employment for over 135 graduates at the federal level. My own belief is that I have a seed agenda before I was elected to represent them. The seed agenda, seed represents service to the people, education, enterprise, and development. That's my seed. It's a four-point agenda. And the term for which I was engaged to represent them is the first term is 4 years. And I have four-point agenda. Seed, service to the people, educational development, enterprise development, and development of infrastructure in my local community that I represent. And I am proud to say today that in terms of power generation, have been able to bring, a lot of power generation to ease the life of my people in terms of providing transformers to them. Over 150 transformers have been distributed to every nooks and crannies of Ondo Central. Have been able to do a lot of power projects. Over 50 rural electrification projects have been physically executed. Then again, I have been able to, because of my belief in entrepreneurial development scheme, my first year in the Senate, that's 2012 budget, I was able to use my constituency budget to provide three key acquisition centers, worth an average of 120 million each. One in Ondo Central, Ondo East and West Federal Constituency that I located in Ondo Boys High School. We have a big entrepreneurial development center in Ondo Boys High School. I have one in Oyemeku Grammar School representing Akure North and South Federal Constituency. I have one establishing Olof Grammar School Idari, representing Idari Federal Constituency. Apart from that, health programs have been able to establish a lot of health centers within my central district. So to provide empowerment program worth over 150 million in my first year of office, marking my first year in office. This constituency office we are speaking from today was built to ensure that I am accessible to the people that I'm representing in the Senate. Because when I was conversing for their votes, I made it clear to them that I'm a man of integrity, I believe in my words, and I will do likely what I promised them. I said, I will never be a senator that will go to Obadiachila Road and rent a one-shop apartment where you only have, a clerk, maybe OND holder, who will only be receiving telephone calls. I'm going to establish a constituency office that will incorporate a skill acquisition center that will be of modern, that will be able to provide modern infrastructures for people to develop themselves, for people to be able to be an employer of labor, not to be an employee. Because I know if I, without any assistance from anybody except God, that I was able to be determined that I will sustain this economy without any helper, and I'm here today, I believe they can even do better because there are more infrastructures today. Without even living from Akure to Abuja, you can send information through mails now and get it done. That was why it is possible for me to have been able to engage over 135 graduates. Not many of them, I don't know them. I only leave my telephone number, my email address in my constituency office. Let them come here. People are looking for job. Send your CV to Ondo Central Job Placement @yahoo.com. That is the email I open for all the people in my constituents. Any mail that comes to that particular, my secretary manager has a mandate. When he sits in there, I sit in the first mail, download every CV and credentials from that particular mail. I know these are for my constituents. That was why it is possible for me to have enough credentials to recommend to various parties of government that are employed. Most these employed, they will never advertise it. But those of us who are in contact with them, who supervise them, know when they are employed. And as a matter of fact, and as a matter of principle, I made it my first protocol that every morning, what can I do to add value to my people? That's the question I answer when I go to National Assembly on a daily basis. And by the grace of God today, I think I have enough, a lot to show for it. Recently, I mean, I heard that Nigerian Communication Commission are giving backup facilities, IT facilities for tertiary institutions across the country. Immediately, I applied for Federal University of Technology Akure for them to at least give them not less than 100 computer system for them to be able to have enough infrastructure to train students to be IT compliant. I applied for them to supply the same thing to Adeyemi College of Education. Yeah, that has already been done through my intervention. If there were nobody, no good representation there, all this thing would be distorted to other central issues without remembering on those central.
How do you determine the bill to be passed, an issue to be decided at the level of the Senate? Because Nigeria, as in, we have a lot of problems. At first, it was a gay marriage, and now the child acts marriage. How do you determine what's to be discussed?
Well, you see, every senator is representing a district in the upper chamber of National Assembly. Nigeria has divergent opinion about issues. If you say this is what you want your people, you can come with a motion, you can come with a bill. This bill will be discussed. If it is discussed and get to top majority or simple majority, it is passed. The issue of gay marriage will be brought to them, will throw it away. It never happened because Nigeria doesn't want it. We kill it. That bill was dead on arrival. And then we quench it. So the thing is that any senator can come with a bill, can come with a motion that this is what I want other people to vote in favor. By the time we debate it for and against, the senator will rule. If it is the majority, if the majority want it to settle, we will pass it. The passage of bills in the National Assembly just take only a simple majority. Passage of bills or motion is once the eyes have it, the Senator knocks and rule. But when you talk about passage of clause of constitution, is very, very fundamental. Because this is the law that bows over Nigeria. This is the law that is very supreme and predominant. This is the law that any other law bows down for. Therefore, it must take a process that everybody in Nigeria must have a say on it. That's why we have 36 House of Assembly, the Federal Capital Territory 37. We have 109 senators, 36 states plus one senator in the federal. So we have a process of the process of amending any clause of the constitution involves two-thirds majority. That is, today we have 109 senators. Two-thirds of 109 is 73 vote. For any passage, for any clause of constitution to pass through in the Senate, 73 senators must vote in favor. If 72 people voted in favor, then the Senate president rules to make 73. So, after that passage in the Senate, the same law will be passed by a two-thirds majority of 260 members in the House of Assembly, in the National 360 members of the National Assembly of the Royal House of the House of Rep. We have 360 House of Rep members. Two-thirds of it is 240. That is, for any clause of constitution to pass in the lower chamber, minimum of 240 members will vote in favor. Then, in any matter where the opinion of the Senate differ from that of the House of Rep, in passing either a clause or a bill, they will now meet in a conference. Okay. A conference committee announces it out, clause by clause. So in this case now, any clause of the Constitution that the opinion of the Senate differ from that of the House of Rep, they are going to meet in a conference committee. In the conference committee again, representative of the House of Rep and that of the Senate will now come on a conference table and be considering one after the other. The Senate will abuse his reason for taking his own action. The House of Rep will abuse his reason for taking that action. Then finally, it's either they adopt House position or Senate position for a particular clause. After that process, in considering the clauses of the amended constitution now, after the conference committee now, the National Assembly will now have a common position. That common position now will now be sent to all the 36 states of House of Assembly for again to consider it one clause by clause again to vote for or against. Again, too, for them to pass a clause there, they also need two-thirds majority of members of each House of Assembly. At the end of the consideration, then if minimum of 24 House of Assembly is able to adopt a particular law in line with the position of the National Assembly, then that particular clause becomes the law of the land. So each of the clauses considered by Senate, House of Rep, then when they get to the committee room, the conference committee, the final position of the National Assembly is not final until the new 36 House of Assembly vote in favor or against. If they voted against and they cannot achieve 24 House of Assembly for a particular call, that particular remain the way it is before. But if they are able to achieve minimum of 24 State House of Assembly to vote in favor, in line with, that is, for the 24 State House of Assembly to be, for the opposition to be in line with that National Assembly, then that particular law clause becomes the law of the land. So we are in the first process. Only of 8 months, like I said, the Senate never discussed anything about child marriage at all. We only discussed renunciation of Nigerian citizenship under the Constitution. Section 29 of the Constitution provides that any person who is of full age can renounce his or her citizenship under the Federal Republic of Nigeria Constitution. That was the clause we voted for. And today, I have made my own clarification, and no Nigeria can visit my website, www.senatorakinyelureondocentral.com, to look at my position. We never voted for underage marriage, and I never voted for underage marriage. I am a Yoruba man to the core. I am born and bred in Yoruba land. I know the culture of my people. I cannot go to National Assembly and vote against the wish of the people who sent me there. The seat I'm sitting down in National Assembly belongs to Ondo Central. It's not my property. I'm only a trustee of that position. That trustee, they gave me the trustee for 4 years. That seat, that red seat, I sit in the chamber. The one I sit in my office belongs to Ondo Central. It's not my property. I'm only an occupant to do the wish of my people. Today, when the media misinterpreted the vote of the Senate that we voted under my people were making note that I could all over do this one. For respect for democracy, because we talk about democracy, they call me and say they had this. I said, come, I will come here to come and explain my action. My action is to save Nigeria from being thrown into religious crisis, and I've defended it. I never denied my action. My action is I voted for renunciation of citizenship under the Constitution. And when I look at the advantage, figure, this clause is already existing in the Constitution since 1999. We never fought ourselves. There were no fight of North-South problem. If taking a decision to remove it from the Senate is going to cost it, I voted say let it remain. And that was the position of the Senate. But today, that is not final. There are amendments to it. The Senate and the House of Assembly is going to meet in a conference to adopt a position that Nigerians will love. And today, I made it clear to my people that come, I never voted for underage marriage. I voted for renunciation of citizenship under the Constitution. The Senate position is so clear. Visit my website, www.senatorakinyelureondocentral.com. For the people all over the world, look at it. I never did what you say I did. This is what I did. And if your interpretation is different from me, I offer my full apology. And that is a respect for democracy. If I were bound to be served by a woman godfather, I would say to hurt with all of them. I will only respect the view of my godfather, But I was never bonded to descended by any godfather. I was bonded to descended by one man, one vote. And I was democratically elected to make a difference. And that difference I've been making since I got to the National Assembly for my people.
What's your advice to our youth out there?
Yeah, my advice is for them to be steadfast and not to take issues without knowing the meaning. Because these issues are generating a lot of controversy because they don't know what they are even, you know, fighting for. You see, when there's an allegation, you listen to that person to hear his own side very well so that before you start, you know. So my own advice to the people is to be calm. I'm a distinguished senator representing the interests of Ondo Central in the right way in the National Assembly. I am there to add value to Ondo State. The benefit of being there is the my being there is their own benefit to ensure that I add value to them. And that's what I've been doing. Today, I am able to say that I have account of my stewardship in black and white. And they are verifiable. So I get to the Senate. When they visit my website, they will know what I have done to add value in the last 2.5 years, in the last 2 years, 3 months I've been in the Senate. I want to appeal to all of them to be calm and again to be forward-looking, not to listen to political propagandas that want to derail Ondo State. Ondo State is a state that should be used as benchmark for everything in Africa, not even in Nigeria, for in Africa. We are Labour Party in Ondo State and we are proud to be a Labour Party. And we have our programs have been benchmarked by World Bank, by United Nations. People than other states of Nigeria use Ondo State as a benchmark. If we take a position on an issue, others should come and emulate us. My people in Ondo Central, they should be calm. I am the single senator that they voted for, and I remain all over one.
Just been perspectives on your number one television, OSR, so the nation's chat station. For the past few minutes, we've been chatting with Senator Dr. Pratt Ayo Akinyelure, the senator representing Ondo Central Senatorial District at the Senate, and is also the chairman Senate's Committee on Ethics, Privileges, and Public Petitions. Over now to the studios, where we'll wrap up the show.